Once you know your sovereignty, you will challenge anything that attempts to take that away from you. And let me tell you, a person who walks in their sovereignty is powerful. Shane here. Thanks for joining me. Hope you're doing well. I'd like to invite you to subscribe to my channel if you find the content engaging and helpful. If not, I wouldn't subscribe either. Hope you're doing well. It's a beautiful day where I am. The birds are singing and everything is as it should be. My expectations and reality are very much in alignment, because energy flows where attention goes. So there's this thing called sovereignty that I hear a lot about, and I speak a lot about it. Personal sovereignty. So to claim that you're a sovereign being, which you are, and to come from that place is very liberating and empowering. And to know that you are sovereign is incredibly powerful. But with that comes a deep, deep responsibility. And that is, when you see the sovereignty in yourself and you acknowledge that, you must also see that same sovereignty in your brother and sister. That is the disconnect for so many. I'm sure you've seen it, I'm sure you've heard it, and I'm sure you've experienced it. Being a sovereign being means that you respect yourself. You see the sacredness within you. You know that all power comes from within. That's the eighth and the sixth principles working together. What does sovereignty mean? Sovereignty, being sovereign, knowing and identifying your sovereignty means that you will walk away from people, places, situations, mindsets that don't serve you and your higher calling. You won't settle for what you know isn't right. You won't stay in a place that isn't serving you and building you up and adding to your best possible outcome. Knowing that you're a sovereign being gives you that power and that knowing to acknowledge those things and to deal with those things. So personal sovereignty also is the acknowledgement that you are a part of the divine. You are indeed a divine being, having a physical experience here on the earth. But we all are, so you're not special just because of that. Even the caterpillar that chews the leaves is a divine being having a physical experience here on the earth. Knowing your sovereignty does not give you the right, or being a sovereign being does not give you the right to be filled with self-importance. It does not give you the right to neglect the people and the things around you that need your attention. Seeing the sacredness in another means that you respect that other person, thing, because all things are sacred. So seeing the sovereignty and the sacredness within another means that you treat them as you would treat yourself. Coming from that knowledge base that you are sovereign. And this is what's wrong with the world today. This is why we have people starving, homeless, in lack. Because they have never identified the sovereignty within themselves. And the people around them who identify the sovereignty within themselves have never taken that outside of themselves to make the world around them a better place. When you see the sacredness and the sovereignty in another, you act from that place. It's interesting that we are, you know, there is an attack on sovereignty, and we are experiencing that. We're seeing that everywhere. Personal sovereignty and personal choice is under attack because this system that we all live in, well, when I say live in, this system that exists on the earth with us, which is collapsing, let me remind you of that, it cannot cope with sovereign beings rising up in their strength and their power, because once you know your sovereignty, you will challenge anything that attempts to take that away from you. And let me tell you, a person who walks in their sovereignty is powerful. And you know, the shamanic path calls us to be sovereign. It calls us to identify that sovereignty within us. You know, you don't see your brothers and sisters as a lesser being or a lesser human. This is not how it works. So when you see the sovereignty within yourself, you should also see that within your brothers and sisters. This is the way forward, and this is how it will be in this new age we're moving into. Because in the age of Aquarius, we are going to be very much about community. And effective communities recognize the sovereignty in all and the sacredness in all. We don't put ourselves on pedestals and sit on thrones anymore. That's seeing the sovereignty in yourself, but from such an unhealthy position that you exalt yourself above all others and have them serve you. We are all to serve one another. This is the spiritual way. This is the divine way. To know that we are all sovereign and divine is empowering. And when we bring that together and we accumulate that energy and that focus, there are no limits. You know, the shamanic principles are so powerful. And to not live in them is to your detriment, and to not walk in them and understand them and know them through every situation in your life is to your detriment. And to walk the shamanic path without knowing the nine principles intimately, I would have to question whether or not you are actually walking the shamanic path, because those nine principles moving in alignment and working in alignment are extremely powerful and fundamental to the absolute existence of the shamanic way. I hope this has helped you. I hope that you understand where I'm coming from. You are a sovereign being, and you need to do all that you can to acknowledge that, to walk in that, and to protect that. And shining that light of awareness into the hearts of other people so that they might too see their own sovereignty. That's powerful, and it's a beautiful thing to witness. I hope you have a great day. I am going to be grounding myself in my Mother Earth by gardening. I have some new nettle plants to plant, lots of herbs to plant. Now I'd love to talk to you about this, but you know, I'm not an expert on this stuff, but I've grown and used my own medicinal and healing herbs for, I don't know, over 30 years, probably 40 years. As a kid, I would do this. And there's real power in knowing what and how our earth provides things to heal us and keep us well. So that's another story for another day. But that's what I'll be doing right now, grounding myself in the beautiful earth. And that in itself brings us healing. And I need a little bit You might be able to tell by my voice, but some little intruder has gotten in there and decided to try and bring me down a little bit, but I'm pretty resilient. There's another story for another day. Have a great day, everyone. Talk soon.